Working offshore is not easy. Many things can go wrong. You need to be prepared and accept that fact. But how can you prepare if you don't know if something is going to go wrong? So when you go out for work offshore, you have to assume that everything will go wrong. So let's start from ground zero. Things starts to go wrong when some over-enthusiast over-promises the client about something which he has no idea about. Most of the time he is trying to get more jobs for the company. You can't blame him for that. He is just doing his part of job, and that's how the whole industry is made. After some tense negotiation, the job passes through sales, commercials, business line, project manager, and then it comes to you.
This is a very prestigious project. We finally got this client after a long time. We cannot mess it up. We must keep the high standards and deliver on time.
But you can't just take your minds off that enormous crying baby with fully laden diaper. It's now your baby. Sounds familiar? I know many of you have been in this situation before, including me. And if I were you, I'll sit down with a piece of pen and paper and start writing down the things that can go wrong, may go wrong, and will go wrong. And then I will write down all the what ifs, every possibilities. What if there are bed bugs? What if the antenna breaks? What if the toefish gets lost? What if the toilet overflows? What if the boat sinks? You know what I mean, right? And then I will sit down and write all the things that I can and will do if something goes wrong. But believe me, you will always come up short of ideas. You cannot have backup for everything. How do they say it?
No. This is commercially not viable. You will have to make do with whatever we are giving you. Don't worry.
The moment you hear the word don't worry, your worries quadruples. But that happens with all the unknowns. It's not in your hand. You should concentrate on what you can control. So what is in your control? Initial setup, right? Measure the offsets of your sensors as accurately as possible, and I mean including heights and drafts. These are the basics, and most of the basic data problems starts from here. Do your calibrations right and then redo it again, especially for heading sensors, motion sensor and multibeam. Remember, just 1 degree of an error can cause a spatial shift of about 1.7 meter in 100 meter distance. Now you may ask, what is 1 degree? 1 degree is equivalent to your pinky held at arm's length, and from your position is the angle from one side of the pinky to the other side. And that's it. It's actually very easy to misalign your sensors with vessels fore and aft line. And that's why a rigorous double verified calibration is most important. Your vessel is like a rigid reference frame with all the sensors offsets and the alignments acting as an one entity. You get it right for the first time and half of your worries are gone. Next is your geodesy and vertical datum. You get it wrong and you could be surveying in Singapore instead of Chennai. Blame it on moon, but you have to have your vertical datums right, or these pesky tides can leave you high and dry. Now you have to solve some data quality issues. Thanks to bad line keeping, rough weather, engine noise, vibrating and wobbling sensor poles, sound velocity changes, USBL position jumping. But then you know what to do, right? That's why you were chosen as a team leader. One of the most important issues that can make life miserable is time. So get your NTP sorted out properly, or the time stamping of the data will be a big issue. Don't forget to check the capacity of your router. With so much of data is being recorded every second that 1 Gbps router is almost completely obsolete. But then again, these all are predictable problems which either you or someone has already faced it before. Your job is to predict the unpredictable and prepare beforehand. I can't say what it can be. The question is out there, and you have to go and give your answers out there only. practice, discussion and preparation can only prepare you for the predictable problems. Your common sense and your adaptability can save you from rest of the problems. It's like doing PhD on different subjects every time you go out to sea. Every project is different and there will always be some issues and problems with one thing or another. At the end of your project, take out your list again and see what came true and what remained to be seen. Your final outcome will depend on how you approach a problem. There will always be some residual problem when you come back to shore, but then again, you have to know how to hand over the crying baby.